Today we're talking all about easy vegan freezer breakfast recipes that you guys can make at the start of your week, start of your month, so that your freezer is chock full of healthy recipes that you can reheat and start your day with. We're making savory vegan breakfast burritos, two different flavors of baked oatmeal cups, as well as two different flavors of sheet pan pancakes, and some protein yogurt cups. And remember that all of the recipes can be found in the description box, as well as a free downloadable PDF that you can print and have on hand whenever you need. All right, let's get started. So I want to show you guys a savory option first with these easy vegan breakfast burritos. We love these all throughout the day, but they're super fun for a savory breakfast option. To start, you're going to press some tofu either with a press or some heavy books. Then you're going to make a marinade for your tofu with some olive oil, soy sauce, spices. Whisk that all together and then crumble your pressed tofu into the bowl. Next, just use a spatula or spoon to coat all of the tofu in the marinade until nice and seasoned. And then you're gonna pour this onto a baking sheet. I love to use just an unlined baking sheet with some cooking spray on it, and that allows the tofu to get really crispy. You're gonna pop this into the oven and start on your veggies. So I just like to use some bell pepper and onion, and we're also gonna roast these in the oven, and this makes it really easy to whip up this recipe. Just coat the veggies in some olive oil and salt, and then put these in the oven alongside the tofu. While your tofu is roasting and your veggies are roasting, you can prepare the other ingredients. I just like to use some cheddar cheese, and I just shred that myself. And then we are going to prepare these breakfast burritos. So I like to get really large tortillas, about 10 inch in size. I add on some canned refried beans, the roasted veggies, my tofu taco crumbles, the cheese, and then salsa before rolling these up nice and tight. I would love to find a more environmentally friendly way of wrapping these so they don't get freezer burn, but I'm still using aluminum, so if you have any suggestions or know that it works without aluminum, please let me know. And you're just going to continue this until you get about 8 burritos is what you should get from the recipe. And you're going to store these in a bag, and they will be super easy to reheat whenever you want something savory for breakfast or for quick lunches and dinners even. To reheat these burritos, you're just gonna remove them from the foil, place them on a plate, and then zap them in the microwave for about 5 minutes or until they're heated through. You could add on some fresh avocado or cilantro, but these are ready to go as is. Next up, I'm gonna show you two different flavors of baked oatmeal muffin cups. Whenever I'm making a bunch of freezer meals at one time, I like to whip up different flavors if possible, just so we can switch up our breakfast throughout the week and don't get sick of the same meal over and over and over again. So for these Chunky Monkey oatmeal cups, I'm gonna start by whisking together all of the wet ingredients, which these are made with a base of mashed banana for sweetness, and that kind of gives them the Chunky Monkey flavor, before adding in my oats, chocolate chips, and crushed walnuts. And this will just make a really thick oatmeal batter, and you're just gonna spoon these into your muffin cups, and I like to top them with a little more chocolate and walnuts before popping these into the oven to bake until set. I usually let the muffin cups cool a little bit in the pan before removing them to a wire rack to cool completely before putting them in a freezer safe Ziploc bag and placing them in the freezer for whenever we need them. And for the next flavor I want to show you, it's a cinnamon roll inspired baked oatmeal muffin cup, and these are basically the exact same recipe as the Chunky Monkey ones, except instead of using mashed banana, we're going to start with applesauce just so they have a more neutral flavor. And once we have the base of these muffin cups prepared, we are going to use another separate bowl to whip up some cinnamon roll swirl filling of sorts that we will make a nice layered effect with these oatmeal muffin cups. So for the filling, you're going to use some almond butter, coconut sugar, and cinnamon and create this really sweet, thick paste. And then to make these cups, you're just going to put half of the batter into your muffin cup, put in a little bit of the cinnamon swirl filling before topping it with the rest of the batter and baking them in the oven until set. Again, you're just going to want to let these cool completely before you put them in a freezer safe Ziploc bag and freeze them for later. Whenever possible, I love to use these reusable silicone freezer bags that I will be sure to link down below in case you're interested in checking them out. To reheat these baked oatmeal muffin cups, we usually just put them on a microwave safe plate, zap them in the microwave, and then top them with our favorite nut butters and fruit. Another great freezer breakfast that I love to make all the time are these sheet pan pancakes. I've showed them in some other videos before, but I'll show you guys here again. To start, I'm gonna make some whole wheat banana pancakes, and I'm gonna be using some flax eggs, which I just made at the start before whisking together all of my wet ingredients, including mashed banana, almond milk, a little bit of liquid sweetener, a touch of oil, baking powder, baking soda, and salt. And then you're gonna add in your thickened flax eggs before whisking this all together and then folding in your whole wheat flour. Then all that's left to do is to pour this batter into a sheet pan. You could either use a quarter sized sheet pan or a 9x13 inch baking dish. It'll be super thin, but that's exactly how you want it. Spread it out and then bake these at a high temperature for just about 15 minutes until cooked through. Then you just let everything cool before slicing this basically cake into pieces, and you will be left with these fluffy, freezeable sheet pan pancakes that are perfect for quick and easy breakfasts all month long. Again, I wanted to show you that you can create the same recipe, basically just two different flavors, so that your breakfasts remain exciting throughout the month. So I'll be sure to leave my fluffy pumpkin sheet pan pancake recipe down in the description as well as in the free PDF. Lastly, I wanted to share a recipe for some protein yogurt cups. And to make these, you're gonna line some muffin cups with silicone muffin liners. And then I actually found that my Energy Bite recipe worked great as a base for these, but you could also use some granola. For the mousse or the protein yogurt filling, you're just gonna mix together your favorite kind of protein powder as well as some non-dairy yogurt until a thick mousse texture forms. Then you're just gonna put this onto your granola or Energy Bite base, push it down so that it sticks well to the base, and pop these in the freezer until they're nice and chilled and set. And we love to let these thaw in the fridge for a little bit before eating them. They kind of taste like ice cream, but you definitely need to enjoy the protein powder you use as well as the non-dairy yogurt, so just keep that in mind. But these were just a fun, refreshing breakfast to have on hand. All right, guys, I could share so many other recipes with you, but I'm gonna stop there. So if you wanna see another video of freezer breakfast recipes, please give this video a like. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any other videos. Download the free PDF in the description box, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.